नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं वाचं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। जितं ते पुण्डरीकाक्ष नमस्ते विश्वभावन नमस्तेस्तु हृषीकेश महापुरुष पूर्वज सदक्षरं ब्रह्म ये ईश्वरः पुमान् गुणोर्मिसृष्टिस्थितिकालसल्लयः प्रधानबुद्ध्यादिजगत्प्रपञ्चसूः सनोस्तु विष्णुर्मतिभूतिमुक्तितः। तस्य ऋषभो अभवत् पुत्रो मेरुदेव्यां महाद्युतिः ऋषभात् भरतो जज्ञे ज्येष्ठः पुत्रशतस्य सह कृत्वा राज्यं स्वधर्मेण तथा इष्ट्वा विविधान् मखान् अभिषिच्य सुतं ज्येष्ठं भरतं पृथिवीपतिं तपसेस महाभागः पुलस्त्यस्य आश्रमं ययौ वानप्रस्थविधानेन तत्रापि कृतनिश्चयः तपस्तेपे यथान्यायं यदा च स महीपतिः तपसा कर्षितोऽत्यर्थं कृशो धमनि सन्ततः व्याप्तः इति। सो वी टाकिङ्ग् अबौट् दि वंशावळि आफ् द किङ्ग्स् हू वर् देर् मेन्ली प्रियव्रतस् वंश हियर्। ऋषभः अभवत् तस्य पुत्रः, दट् इस् आफ्टर् प्रियव्रत यु हेड् सम्बडि, अदकप्रं यु हेव् ऋषभ ऐ थिङ्क्। एण्ड् ऋषभस्य पुत्रः तु भरतः, अत्र भरतः एव ज्येष्ठः पुत्रः आसीत्। या भरतः ज्येष्ठः आसीत् लि आम यस् प्रियव्रतः, प्रियव्रतात् ऋषभः, नाभि एण्ड् देन् यु हेव् ऋषभ, ऋषभस्य पुत्रः एव भरतः। ऋषभस्य तु पुत्रशतं, हि हेड् 100 सन्स् एण्ड् द एल्डेस्ट् वन् वास् भरत। हि गेव् द किङ्ग्डम् टु भरत एण्ड् देन् ऋषभ वेण्ट् टु द फारेस्ट् एस् हि वास् डूयिङ्ग् तपस्। सः अतीव कर्षितः अभूत् कृशत्वकारणात् तस्य आल् द ट्यूब्स् आल् केम् औट् एण्ड् दे वर् वेरि विसिबल्, ऐदर् वेन्स् आर् नर्व्स् एण्ड् आल् देट् वेर् आल् सीङ्ग्। सो धमनि सन्ततः सः कृशः अभूत् इति उक्तम्। नग्नो वीटां मुखे दत्त्वा वीराध्वनं ततः गतः ऋषभः। वि आर् स्टिल् टाकिङ्ग् अबौट् द किङ्ग् ऋषभ हू वास् रोमिङ्ग् अराउण्ड् विदौट् एनी क्लोत्स्, नग्नः भूत्वा वीटां मुखे दत्त्वा, वीटा इस् कन्दुकसदृशम् अश्मकबलं, दिस् इस् जस्ट् होल्डिङ्ग् ஒரு கூழங்கல்ல வாயில வச்சுட்டு போகிறதுங்கிறோம். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் லைக் ஹி வாஸ் ஜஸ்ட் ஹோல்டிங் எ பீஸ் ஆஃப் ராக் இன் ஹிஸ் மவுத். டூ திங்ஸ், ஒன் இஸ் ஹி மே நாட் வாண்ட் டு டாக் டு எனிபடி தேர், த செகண்ட் இஸ் இட் இஸ் லைக் இட் வில் ஜென்ரேட் சலைவா அண்ட் தட் இட் செல்ஃப் வுட் பி இனஃப் ஆஸ் அன் ஆஹாரம் தேர், நத்திங் எல்ஸ் ஹி நீட்ஸ் ஹியர், ஹி வாண்ட் பி ஈட்டிங் தட் ராக். ஓகே, அஷ்மா இத்தியுக்தே இட் இஸ் அ ராக் விச் இஸ் லைக் ஒன் ஹியூஜ் பால் ஆஃப் ராக் விச் ஹி புட்ஸ் இன் இஸ் மவுத் just so that he doesn't have to talk to people and aharastu tatra nagacchati iti. Evam mukhe vitam datva, having placed a ball of rock in his mouth, rishabha viradhvanam gataha. Viradhvanam here is mahaprasthanam, which means you know how our Arjuna and others all went on this mahaprasthanam where they go for their last journey. They go up the mountains and go beyond the Himachala Pradesha and go directly into Narakam or Swargam or wherever, whatever they want. So it is called a Mahaprasthanam, which is the final journey of their life. That is also called Viradhva. So Viradhvanam tataha gataha. ततश्च भारतं वर्षम् एतत् लोकेषु गीयते भरताय यतः पित्रा दत्तं प्रातिष्ठत वनम्। नो दीस् टू लैन्स् फार्म् वन् सेण्टेन्स् हियर्, यतः बिकास् आफ् द रीज़न् दट् वनं प्रातिष्ठत, प्रातिष्ठन् इत्युक्ते वन् हू हेज़् स्टार्टेड् गोयिङ्ग्, वनाय यः प्रस्थानं करोति स एव वनं प्रातिष्ठन् इति उक्तमत्र। सो वनं प्रातिष्ठन् पितुः, पिता वनं प्रातिष्ठता पित्र, बै द फादर् हू वास् स्टार्टिङ्ग् टु गो टु हिस् वनं रैट् बिफोर् ही लेफ्ट् टु द फारेस्ट्, पित्रा दत्तं भरताय पित्रा एतद् वर्षं दत्तं दिस् सिटि दिस् रीजन् भारतवर्षं वास् गिवन् टु भरत बै हिस् फादर् हू हेड् स्टार्टेड् गोयिङ्ग् बिफोर् गोयिङ्ग् टु द फारेस्ट् तस्मात् ततः बिकास् आफ् दट् रीज़न् एतत् दिस् रीजन् इस् काल्ड् लोकेषु गीयते इट् इस् प्रोक्लेम्ड् इन् दिस् वर्ल्ड् द एज़् भारतवर्ष बिकास् दिस् रीजन् वास् गिवन् टु भरत बै हिस् फादर् दिस् वर्ष दिस् रीजन् इस् काल्ड् भारतवर्ष सुमतिः भरतस्य अभूत्पुत्रः परमधार्मिकः सुमति वास् द सन् आफ् भरत who was also paramadharmikaha. He was a great dharma buddhivan. He was a follower of dharma. He did not sway away from dharma path. Kritva samyak dadau tasmai rajyam ishtamakaha pita. Pita bharataha ishtamakaha, having performed makha yagas as he pleased, pujita makaha. Whatever yajnas he wanted to perform, he performed all of those yajnas. Rajyam samyak rajyam kritva, having enjoyed the rajyam also, having ruled the kingdom really well. Tasmai dado sumatye dado, to sumati sumat ama mate to he gave it to his son sumati. Putra sankramita shrihi tu bharataha samahipatihi yogabhyasa rataha प्राणान् शालग्रामे अत्यजत् मुने नौ दीस् टू विल् कम्बैन् एस् अ सेण्टेन्स् हे मुने पुत्रसङ्क्रामितश्रीः भरतः भरतः महीपतिः नृपः हू हेड् एन्श्योर्ड् दट् दिस् श्री राज्यलक्ष्मी वास् ट्रान्स्फर्ड् टु हिस् सन् वन् हू हेड् ट्रान्स्फर्ड् द श्री टु हिस् सन् पुत्रे सङ्क्रामिता श्रीः येन सह इति बहुव्रीहि अत्र स्वपुत्र संक्रामित श्रीः भरतः महीपतिः द किंग हू हैड ट्रांसफर्ड हिज वेल्थ टू हिज सन योगाभ्यास रतः बीइंग वेरी इन्वॉल्वड इन योगाभ्यास डूइंग द प्रैक्टिसेस ऑफ योग अष्टांग योग शालग्रामे अत्यजत प्राणान ही लेफ्ट हिज लाइफ इन शालग्राम वी सॉ दिस शालग्राम बिफोर आल्सो ड्यूरिंग नाभि राइट नाभिः एव तत्र शालग्रामे अगच्छति और नो प्रॉबब्ली इट इज शालग्रामम स भूमिपः द फर्स्ट वन विच इज प्रियव्रतः या हाँ प्रियव्रत वेंट टू शालग्राम द सेम भरत आल्सो वेंट टू शालग्राम एंड ही पास्ड अवे अजायत च विप्रह असौ योगिनां प्रवरे कुले दिस भरत because of whom this entire Bharata Varsha, this Varsha was called, this region was called Bharata, that Bharata was next born as a Brahmana, Vipraha Asau Ajayata, Kutra Kasmin Kule, Yoginam Pravare Kule, in a great family of yogis, great ascetics. He was born in the family of ascetics as a Brahmana. मैत्रेय तस्य चरितं कथयिष्यामि ते पुनः कथयिष्यामि फ्यूचर ही इज़ नॉट गोइंग टू गो इनटू दैट स्टोरी नाउ ही इज़ गोइंग टू फिनिश ऑल द वंशावलीज दिस पर्सन हू वाज़ द सन ऑफ हूम वन बाय वन ओके सो तस्य चरितं इत्युक्ते विप्र विप्र जन्म लब्धः यः भरतः तस्य विप्रस्य कथां तु anyatha you know I will talk about it in another circumstance is was he saying so tasya charitam tasya viprasya charitam tu te punaha kathayishyami I will again tell about this story later sumatehe tejasah tasmat tejasah sumatehe dharmikah parama dharmikah sumatihi tasmat sumatehe panchami from sumati indradyumna was born इन्द्रद्युम्नः व्यजायत इन्द्रद्युम्न वाज द सन् आफ् सुमति परमेष्टि ततः इन्द्रद्युम्न सन् वाज परमेष्टि तस्मात् प्रतिहारः परमेष्टि सन् वाज प्रतिहार तदन्वयः तस्मात् परमेष्टिनः तदन्वयः प्रतिहारः जातः सो तस्मात् परमेष्टिनः फ्रम् परमेष्टि प्रतिहार वाज बोर्न एज़ हिज सन् प्रतिहर्ता इति विख्यातः तस्य आत्मजः उत्पन्नः कृष्ण तस्य आत्मजः प्रतिहारस्य आत्मजः प्रतिहर्ता इति विख्यातः उत्पन्नः ए सन् वाज़ बॉर्न टू प्रतिहार कॉल्ड प्रतिहर्ता विख्यातः ही वाज़ फेमस इति प्रसिद्धः भवः तस्मात् तस्मात् इत्युक्ते प्रतिहर्तुः भवः जातः तथा उद्गीतः प्रस्तावः तत्सुतः तथा उद्गीतः भवस्य पुत्रः उद्गीतः उद्गीतस्य पुत्रः तत्सुतः विभुः प्रस्तावः जातः वि केन् नाट् रिमेम्बर् एनी आफ् दीस् नेम्स् इट् इस् जस्ट् वे आफ् यु नो इट्स् लैक् अ पारायणं फोर् अस् हियर् भवस्तस्मात् तथोद्गीतः प्रस्तावस्तत्सुतो विभुः पृथुः ततः अभवत् प्रस्तावस्य पुत्रः पृथुः अभवत् नक्तः नक्तस्यापि गयः सुतः पृथुः ततः अभवत् नक्तः फ्रम् पृथु केम् नक्त नक्तस्य सुतः तु गयः नरः गयस्य तनयः नर वास् द सन् आफ् गय तत्पुत्रः अभूत् विराट् नरस्य पुत्रः विराट् अभूत् तस्य पुत्रः महावीर्यः धीमान् तस्मात् अजायत महावीर्यः धीमान् तस्मात् अजायत हियर् ऐ थिङ्क् द नेम् इस् महावीर वा इल्ल सारी धीमान् हू वास् तस्य पुत्रः सारी नरस्य पुत्र विरजः पुत्रः महावीर्यः धीमान् तस्मात् अजायत महावीर्यस्य पुत्रत्वेन धीमान् अजायत चर्या परमेष्टि प्रतिहार प्रतिहर्ता भव उद्गीत प्रस्तावः पृथुः नक्तः गयः नरः विराट् महावीर्यः धीमान् पदिमूणु राजा वा ओके धीमतः पुत्रः महान्तः महान्तस्तत्सुतश्चाभूत् मनस्युः तस्य च आत्मजः सो वी हेव् महान्तः एण्ड् देन् महान्तस्य पुत्रः मनस्युः सो महान्तः हियर् इस् नाट् इन् द्वितीया बहुवचनं दिस् इस् अ प्रथमा एकवचनं एन् नेम् संज्ञा महान्तः इति कश्चन पुत्रः जातः तस्य धीमतः महान्तस्य पुत्रः एव मनस्युः मनस्योः पुत्रः त्वष्टा त्वष्टुः पुत्रः विरजः विरजस्य पुत्रः रजः सो त्वष्टा त्वष्टुः च विरजः रजः तस्यापि अभूत् सुतः विरजस्य सुतः अभूत् रजः शतजित् रजसः तस्य सोरि शतजित् रजसः तस्य रजस् रजसः पुत्रः शच रजः इति कश्चन तस्य नाम रजसः पुत्रः एव शतजित् शतजित् रजसस्तस्य यज्ञे पुत्रशतं मुने तस्य पुत्रशतं यज्ञे इत्युक्ते शतजित् इत्यस्य शतजितः पुत्रशतम् आसीत् नो शतजित् हेड् हण्ड्रेड् सन्स् अमङ्ग् देम् द फस्ट् सन् वास् काल्ड् विश्वग्ज्योतिः विश्वग्ज्योतिः प्रधानास्ते अय्यो सारि विश्वग्ज्योतिः प्रधानास्ते यैरिमाः वर्धिताः प्रजाः विश्वग्ज्योति वास् द फस्ट् अमङ्ग् द हण्ड्रेड् चिल्ड्रन् दट् वर् बार्न् टु शतजित् and yaihi because of those 100 children imaha prajaha vardhitaha these subjects were all increased because of vishwajit and his 99 brothers tairidam bharata varsham bharatam varsham navabhedam alankritam tesham vamsha prasutaischa bhuktayam bharati pura taihi idam taihi prajabihi athava vishwajik विश्वज्योतिः प्रधानैः पुत्रशतेन बै द हण्ड्रेड् चिल्ड्रन् आफ् शतजित् हू वर् लेड् बै विश्वज्योति दिस् भारतवर्षं नवभेदम् अलङ्कृतं भारतवर्षं तैः इदं भारतवर्षम् अलङ्कृतं दिस् एण्टैर् भारतवर्ष वास् डेकोरेटेड् बै द चिल्ड्रन् आफ् विश्वज्योति एण्ड् हीस् 99 ब्रदर्स् तेषां वंशप्रसूतैः those who were born in their family, Vamsha, this entire Bharati Bhumihi, the Bharata Varsha was enjoyed. This region of Bharata was enjoyed. So Bharati Bhumihi is an adjective to the Bhumi. It was enjoyed by them. Krita Tretadi Sargena Yugakhya Eka Saptatihi Eshaha Swayambhuvaha Sargaha Yenedam Puritam Jagat Varahe Tu Mune Kalpe Purva Manvantara Adhipaha. So this entire Yugam Navabhedam, nine different Jambudvipa is divided into nine parts, because Priyavrata had sons. His first son Vandudeyanga. Dabare Priyavrataha Dadau Tesham Saptanam Saptadvipam. Adhikapra Medatiti. 1 minute. Jambudvipa Ishwaraha Agnidraha. He had Prajapati Samaha Nava Putraha. In the 16th shloka, you had that. So he distributed this into nine parts. So Navabheda. Okay. Krita Tretadi Sargena Yuga Akhyam Eka Saptatihi. There are 71 yugas totally, which are formed by Krita, Treta, Dwapara and Kali. These four Chatur Yugas keep on repeating for 71 times. So that 171 Chatur Yugas together are called one Manvantara. And that Ekasaptati Chatur Yugam is ruled by one Manu, which is Swayambhuva Manu. So Eshaha Swayambhuvaha Sargaha. So this is the Swayambhuva Manu's creation, or during his rule. Yena idam jagat puritam, by whose rule this entire earth was filled, by this Swayambhuva Manu. So we have to go back and remind ourselves that Swayambhuva Manu had two children who were Priyavrata and Uttanapada. Uttanapada's child was Dhruva. Priyavrata's children were all these people that we named now, some 20-25 kings we named, including 100, where the 99 names are not there, luckily for us. Okay, so Eshaha Swayambhuvaha Sargaha Yena Idam Jagat Puritam Kada Puritam Asit Saha Swayambhuva Manuhu Purva Manantara Naradhipaha Asit Varahe Kalpe. In the, see, the Kalpa and Manvantara do not coincide. Yuga and Manvantara do not coincide. There are different ways in which the Kalpa can be divided. You have a Mahakalpam also. Every day there is a Kalpa where there is a Pralayam happening. After 1-4 Chaturyugams are done, you have one Mahapralayam. Adhikapram, after 71 Chaturyugas, it is a Manvantara. It need not coincide with a Kalpa, with a Pralayam after 71 Chaturyugas. It doesn't, the Kalpam can be different, because it is, the Kalpa is determined by which 71 Chaturyugas or something like that, you know. So here, the way he goes, if you look at Sridhara Swami's Vyakhyana, Nanu Tvaya Purvam Uttanapadadayaha Sarvabhomaha Proktaha. You talked about Uttanapada and other kings there before. Idanim Priyavratadayaha Sarvabhomaha Eva Uchyante. See, Uttanapada's descendants were all ruling the entire earth. Now here also Priyavrata's descendants are ruling the entire earth. How would this happen? Was the earth then in 2-3 layers of alternate universe? Apadilla. Then Sridhara Swami himself says, Tachya samakalena sangachate. This will not happen at the same time, because those Manus had a longer lifespan, and Manus' children, as they were closer to the Manus, they also had longer and longer lifespans. Okay, it was only during the Kali Yugam that the lifespan became very less. But the Manu always, even now we have a Manu who is a, he may not be seen by us, but his divine stature is probably still there. You know, he has a presence there. His rules, he rules for 71 Chaturyugas here. That is why it is called a Manvantara here. ओके सो तच्च समकालीन संगच्छते बोथ प्रियव्रत एंड उत्थानपद कैनॉट रूल एट द सेम टाइम देयर डिसेंडेंट्स कैनॉट रूल द एंटायर अर्थ एट द सेम टाइम अतः क्रमः वक्तव्यः सो वी हैव टू गिव ए क्रमम फॉर देम देयर इज अ ऑर्डर फॉर देम तेषां प्रियव्रत अन्वय प्रसूतानां वंशे प्रसूतैः पुरा प्रथमम् इयं भारती भूमिः भुक्ता So that is why in the earlier shloka you had Tesham Vamsha Prasutaihi. So Priyavratasya Vamshe Yeye Jataha Taihi Prathamam Iyam Bhumihi Bhukta. This Bhumi was first enjoyed by Priyavrata's descendants and then you had Uttanapada. Paschat Uttanapada Dibihi Kiyantam Kalam Iyam Bhukta Iti Chet Krita Tretadi Sargena Yugakya Eka Saptatihi. For 71 Chaturyugas, for a Manvantara, for one Manvantara period, Uttanapada's descendants were ruling. This is called Varahe Asmin Kalpe, this Kalpa which is called the Varaha Kalpa, because the Varaha Avatara was described first. We have not had the Matsya Avatara here. We are still in Shweta Varaha Kalpa, right? So this is a Varaha Kalpa that we are being describing here because that is the first avatara that happened in this Kalpa. Okay? So Varahe Asmin Kalpe Swayambhuvaha Purvasya Purvasya ityukte Prathama Manvantara Prathama Manvantarasya Adhipaha Abhuta Swayambhuvaha Manuhu तदा एषः प्रियव्रतवंशानां राज्ञां सर्गः सृष्टिः आसीत् ततः स्वारोचिषादौ उत्तानपाद स्वारोचिष कल्प देन् हेपेण्ड् वेर् उत्तानपादास् वंश आल्सो वेर् प्रेसेण्ट् ओके सो अत एव उत्तानपादवंश्यस्य प्राचेतस दक्षकन्यानां कन्यायाम् आदित्यानां जन्म वैवस्वतमन्वन्तरे उक्तम् So we will talk about Vaivasvata Manvantara later, wherein Aditya and other devatas were all born. Dakshakanya was born, Parvati, Shiva, etc. That story will come later. Okay. So this is Sridhara Swami who is trying to give us some try to make sense of what is happening here, because all said and done, Puranas talk from a very different time frame and time scale, right? So we don't know. How the Bhumi was at that point of time, we are trying to make sense of it from the time frame that we are now. So it can be tough to understand. Iti Shri Vishnu Purane Dvitiyamshe Prathamodhyayaha. Now we move on to the second adhyaya. Atha Dvitiyodhyayaha Maitreya Uvacha. Now Maitreya's question itself will describe what this adhyaya is about. This adhyaya is just about the description, geographical description of Bhumi, the placement of the seven dvipas, seven islands and the mountains within, what are the nadis, the rivers that are flowing in this. It is a geographical description of how it was during Parashara and Maitreya's time. Maitreya Uvacha. कथितो भवता ब्रह्मन् सर्गः स्वायम्भुवश्च मे श्रोतुमिच्छामि अहं त्वत्तः सकलं मण्डलं भुवः भवत हे ब्रह्मन् भवता स्वायम्भुवः मनोः सर्गः कथितः द स्वायम्भुव मनोज सर्गः क्रियेशन् वाज टोल्ड टु मी अबौट यू मे कथितः अहं त्वत्तः Sakalam Bhuvaha Mandalam Shrotum Ichami. Now I want to hear about the entire earth and how it is. Yavantaha Sagaraha Dvipaha Tatha Varshani Parvataha Vanani Saritaha Puryaha Devadinam Tatha Mune. Hey Mune, how many ever oceans are there? Sagaraha Santi Dvipaha Islands Tatha Varshani Regions पर्वताः माउंटेन्स वनानि फॉरेस्ट्स सरितः नद्यः पुर्यः सिटीज देवादीनां पुर्यः सिटीज ऑफ देवास व्हाट आर ऑल देयर तत्सर्वं श्रोतुम इच्छामि यत् प्रमाणं इदं सर्वं यद् आधारं यद् आत्मकं संस्थानम् अस्य च मुने यथावत् वक्तुम अर्हसि यत् प्रमाणं इदं सर्वं व्हाट इज द प्रमाणं दैट इज द मेजरमेंट ऑफ ईच ऑफ दीस थिंग्स That way, how big is Meru Parvatam? How huge is Jambudvipam, etc. What are the measurements of it? Yad Aadharam, what is the basis for all of these? How do people live in these geographical regions? Yad Atmakam, what is the swarupam of this geographical region? Asya Samsthanam, amaippugal, adavadu establishments, how the cities are, uttara dishe evam vartate, asya dakshinataha evam vartate. Iti yathavat vaktum arhasi. You have to tell me how as is it is. Parashara vacha. Maitreya shruyatam etat sankshepad gadato mama na asya varshashatena api vaktum shakyohi vistaraha. Hey Maitreya, listen to this in a very short manner. You know, sankshepat. Gadataha mama sankshepat etat shruyatam. Gadataha mama, as I said, sankshepat gadataha mama etat shruyatam. Listen to this from me, who am speaking in a very concise manner. Aham sankshepat gadami gadataha mama iti tatra shatranta shashti vibhakti. So as I will give you a brief summary, listen to it. Shruyatam asya varsha shatenapi vaktum vistaraha na shakyaha. It is very difficult to talk about this in detail, even for if it takes 100 years. Varsha shatenapi na shakyaha. Even if I talk about it for 100 years, it is not at all possible for me to give you in detail every little thing. That's why in different Puranas, you have different focuses and different, if you look at Skanda Puranam, you have a lot of Kshetra Mahatmyam and all that in that Purana. So it depends. Each Purana has a different focus here. Jambu Plaksha Ahvayau Dvipau. Jambu Dvipa and Plaksha Dvipa are two Dvipas. Shalmalihi cha aparaha. There is another Dvipa called Shalmali, He Dvija. Kushaha Kraunchascha, these are all names of these seven dvipa, seven islands. Shakaha Pushkarascheiva Saptamaha, and Pushkara is the seventh. So Jambudvipaha, Plakshadvipaha, Shalmalidvipaha, Kushadvipaha, Kraunchadvipaha, Shakadvipaha, and Pushkaradvipaha. These are the seven islands. Ete dvipaha samudraistu sapta saptabihi avritaha. These seven islands are surrounded, avritaha, by seven sapta sapta dvipaha. We have to take it like this. Ete sapta dvipaha saptabihi samudraihi avritaha. These are surrounded by seven different oceans. What are those seven different oceans? If you look at the seven different oceans here, none of these are present here now. Physically, you can't even find those seven oceans. We are talking about a different Bhumi Bhagam here, which is in a Brahmandam, which is in your universe here. Lavana Ikshu Sura Sarpihi Dadhi Dugdha Jalaihi Samam. Samam Avritam. It is equally surrounded by all of these seven samudraihi. What are the seven samudras? Lavana, salty water. Ikshu, sugarcane juice. Sura, alcohol, wine, surapanam. Madhu, sarpihi, ghee. Dadhi, curds, yogurt. Dugdha, milk ocean. Jala, shuddha jala. Shuddhodakam. Not salty water, but just sweet like fresh water. So these are the seven oceans that are surrounding the seven islands. Jambudvipaha samastanam esham madhya samsthitaha. Etesham madhya samsthitaha. Etesham dvipanam madhye jambudvipaha vartate. Probably it is only Jambudvipa which is present now as Bhumi. It's difficult to, again, I keep telling you, it is very tough to visualize what they are trying to describe here. So Jambudvipaha samastanam etesham madhya samsthitaha. Jambudvipa is present in the middle of all of these oceans and islands. Tasya api Jambudvipasya meruhu maitreya madhye kanaka parvataha. He maitreya meruhu eva meru kanaka parvataha. This golden mountain of Meru is present in the middle of this Jambudvipa. And now he is moving on to giving the parimanam, that is pramanam, kiyat pramanam iti prishtam maitreyena tattu pramana rupena atra measurements. He gives the measurements for this Meru Parvata. चतुराशीतिसाहस्रो योजनैः अस्य च उच्छ्रयः प्रविष्टः षोडशाधस्तात् द्वात्रिंशन् मूर्ध्नि विस्तृतः. दिस् इस् लैक् ए पद्मं, दिस् इस् लैक् अ लोटस् इन् द मिडिल् आफ् द भूमि. इट् द टाप् पोर्षन् इस् आक्चुलि वेरि वैड् विच् एक्स्टेण्ड्स् टु 32 योजनास्. द्वात्रिंशत् योजनैः मूर्ध्नि विस्तृतः. दिस् मेरुपर्वतम् is 30 yojana, one yojana is nearly 10 to 12 kilometers, okay. It's 8 to 10 miles or 10 to 13 kilometers is the range of a yojana. So here you have 32 yojanas is the distance which is at the top, at the peak portion, and then it is actually shorter. So that is why it says later it describes the Meru Parvatam as a Mahapadmam Karnikaravat iti. It is described the same way in Bhagavatam also. There is a Gadyam portion in Chaturtha Skanda where this entire earth geographical description is given as a Gadyam there in Bhagavatam. So Chaturashiti Sahasraha Ashitihi Eva Ashitihi Sahasram Eva Sahasram. So Chaturashiti Sahasraha Uchrayaha. So the height of this Meru Parvatam is 84,000 yojanas. 84,000 into 12 potukongo. 1 lakh, edo something like that. 100,000 something something is the distance of this mountain. It is nothing about Himalayas or anything. We don't have such a Parvatam now in existence. Physically we cannot see it. It is not usually Puranas are not physical representations. These are also things that are mental, you know. It's a representative of certain things that are there within either the body or within the Brahmandam, universe, everything. These are things which are encoded by people. That's what they say, you know. Many things have been represent symbolic representation of certain things, right? Meru is a symbolic representation of everything that is divine, and Meru Parvatam is supposed to be the residing place of all the devas there. So, and it is also, Meru is a physical representation of the Shri Chakram, where Devi is supposed to be, right? So it's more of a philosophical representation of what we understand about devis and devatas. So Chaturashiti Sahasro Yojanaihi Asya Meroho Parvatasya Uchrayaha. The height of Meru Parvata is 84,000 yojanas. Pravishtaha Adhastatu Shodasha. For 16 yojanas, 16 into 12, you go down. So it has gone down within the, beyond the earth, for 16 yojanas, and then on top it spreads for 32 yojanas. Dvatrimshan Murdhini Vistrataha. That's why I say it is a symbolic representation of probably the troposphere. We don't know what they are talking about, you know, the avaranam around the atmosphere around our earth is probably what he is talking about. We don't know if that is Meru Parvatam. Next is Mule Shodasha Sahasraha Vistaraha Tasya Sarvashaha. If you look at it, Murdhni 32, and it is completely halved when it is in the middle. When it comes to the Moolam. Moolam is where the mountain actually rests. It is like an inverted triangle here. Here it is only 16,000 yojanas Vistaraha. So it is like a padma. Bhu padmasya asya shailesha karnakara samsthitaha. Mule shodasha sahasraha vistaraha tasya sarvashaha. So in the moolam, where it ends, it is actually only 16,000 vistara, 16,000 yojanas. Whereas on top at the peak portion, the Meru Parvatam is 32 yojanas. So bhu padmasya asya, this is like a lotus for the entire earth. Shailesha, this king of all the mountains, it resembles a Karnikara Pushpam. A Karnikara Pushpa is actually very thin like this, and then it spreads out like a bowl on top of the stalk. The same description is given in Bhagavatam also. Himavan Hemakutascha Nishadha cha Asya Dakshine Neelaha Shvetascha Shringi cha Uttare Varshaparvataha. Meru Parvatasya Dakshine Athava Asya Dakshine iti, you can take it as Jambudvipasya Dakshinataha. It says Meru Parvatasya Dakshinataha iti, maybe below Meru Parvata and above Meru Parvata, beyond the Swargam is where, sorry, beyond Bhuhu, you have Swarga where you have the other Hemakuta Parvatam, which is Gandharva region, which is in between Bhuhu and Swarga, Swaha, which is Bhuvaha. Bhur, Bhuvaswaha, Mahaha, Janaha, Tapaha. We go through the lokas in that manner, right? As an avaranam around the Bhumi. So you will have to think of it as you Bhumi, Meru Parvatam, then you have Hemakuta Parvatam, Himavat Parvatam and all. I don't know how they... It's quite confusing here to visualize it. I'm so used to visualizing everything that I teach. So it becomes very difficult for me when I come to these sections. Okay. So I'll just go over the Sanskritam quickly. Himavan Hemakutascha Nishadascha Asya Dakshinataha. It is in the southern region of Meru Parvatam. Himavan, Hemakuta and Nishada. These three are the ranges of mountains. Neelaha, Shvetaha, Shringi. These three mountain ranges are present Uttare, Varsha Parvataha. These are in the northern region of Meru Parvatam. Lakshapramanau Dvau Madhye Dashahi Hinaha Tathacha Apare. Dvau Madhyau, which means I think Nishadha Parvata and Neela Parvata. If you take this is 1, 2, then this is 3, 4, 5 and 6. There are totally 6 Parvatas here. Nishadha and Neela are in the middle. So these two Laksha Pramanau Tatha Apare Dasha Hi Nau. These are Laksha Pramanam Ityukte Laksha Yojana Paryantam Tesham Uchrayaha Vartate. So they're probably their measurements is counted by a lakh. And then there is a 10 less than a lakh for the other four. Sahasra Dvitaya Uchrayaha Tavat Vistarinaha Te. All of them, all six Parvatas are 2000 in height and they are 2000 in Vistara. That is, they are spread across in width also. Bharatam Prathamam Varsham Tataha Kim Purusham Smritam. First area, that is within Jambudvipa, you have 9 areas which were divided by Agnidhra for his 9 children. So those, he is now giving us the geographical establishment, geographical features of these 9 places. Bharatam Prathamam Varsham, Bharata is the first Varsha. Tataha Kim Purusham Smritam, then it is Kim Purusha. Then you have Harivarsha. Harivarsham Tathaiva Anyat. Meroho Dakshinataha Dvija. Meroho Dakshine Parshve. You have these three Varshas, which is Bharata Varsha, Kim Purusha and Harivarsha. Ramyakamcha Uttare Varsham Tasyaiva Anu Hiranmayam Uttaraha Kuravaha Chaiva Yathavai Bharatam Tatha. In the northern section of Meru Parvata, Uttare, Ramyakam Varsham, Tasya Uttare, Meroho Uttare, Athava, Meroho Uttare, Ramyakam Varsham Vartate, Ramyakasya Varshasya Anu, Paschat, after this Ramyaka Varsha, you have Hiranmaya Varsha, then you have Varsha, Uttaraha Kuravaha, the Uttarakuru Varsha is the same as Bharata Varsha. How the it is like a reflection, alternate universe. So Uttarakuru Varsha is like Bharatam only. There is a mention in Mahabharata where Arjuna goes to Uttarakuru. In Kirat Arjunam you have read, he goes to the north and then there are the northern descendants of Kuru Vamsha. He wins over them and brings a lot of wealth to Hastinapuram. Right? Navasahasram ekaikam etesham dvijasattama ಈಚ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ವರ್ಷಸ್ ಭಾರತ ಕಿಂ ಪುರುಷ ಹರಿವರ್ಷ ರಮ್ಯಕ ಹಿರಣ್ಮಯ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಉತ್ತರ ಕುರು ದೀಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ರೀಜನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ 9,000 ಯೋಜನಾಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಲಾವೃತಂ ಚ ತನ್ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಸೌವರ್ಣ ಮೇರುಃ ಸ ಉಚ್ಛ್ರಿತಃ ನೌ ಜಂಬೂದ್ವೀಪಸ್ಯ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ತು ಮೇರು ಪರ್ವತಃ ವರ್ತತೆ ತರ್ಹಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ರೀಜನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೇರು ಪರ್ವತ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಲಾವೃತ ವರ್ಷ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿದಿನ್ ದಿ ಜಂಬೂದ್ವೀಪಂ ಸೊ ಇಲಾವೃತಂ ಚ ತನ್ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಇನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ವರ್ಷಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಿಡಲ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಲಾವೃತ ವರ್ಷಂ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಲಾವೃತ ರೀಜನ್ ತನ್ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಇಲಾವೃತಸ್ಯ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಸೌವರ್ಣ ಸುವರ್ಣಮಯ ಮೇರುಃ ಉಚ್ಛ್ರಿತಃ ಮೇರು ಮೌಂಟನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಟಾಲ್ ಮೌಂಟನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದರ್ ಓಕೆ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವಾಚಂ ತಥೋ ಜಯಮುದೀರಯೇತ್.